Hello everyone, this is Nisha Shetty welcoming you to another super gorgeous episode of Pop Diaries. And why do I call it super gorgeous? Because today we are with the most gorgeous actress of our Hindi cinema, Mirza.
Hi.
Who's essaying the role of Manyata in the movie Sanju. So first of all, like I always say, like I mentioned to you at the red carpet, you look flawless every single time. I want to know her beauty secrets, but since you're giving interviews from a long time now, very first question, I want an honest answer from you. Of course, the entire promotion process was not so aggressive initially when you did movies like Rehna Tere Dil Mein. Now it's, honestly, tell me, is it draining? Is it exciting? Also looking perfect all the time, look one, look two.
No, it's,
how is it?
I'll be honest with you, when I did Rehna Tere Dil Mein, I worked with a producer called Vashu Bhagnani, who even at that time really pushed hard with promotions.
Oh.
I mean, we were on every bus back, we were on every truck back, we were, you know, there was, our faces were planted, plastered everywhere. But that apart, we did strenuous and extensive promotional activities. We traveled to 11 cities, we did on-ground interactions, there was a lot of work,
really?
Lot of work. And I think with every passing year, and this was 2001, with every passing year, I discovered that more than the work that you put into a film, which is of course can be daunting, it was really the promotional work that was exhaustive.
Yes.
And that's exactly how it is even more so now. In fact, I feel that at some level with the way we are promoting Sanju, it's been easier on us as artists.
Really?
Yeah, it hasn't been as strenuous as it's been in the past. But today has been a tough day. I've done some 25 interviews.
Really? Since morning?
Yeah, yeah.
And how do you manage to look so perfect even now after 25 interviews? Look at her!
I don't know if I look perfect.
You do, all the time.
I certainly don't feel perfect. But I think it's just the adrenaline of the film,
yes,
and the energy of the film and the excitement and happiness that keeps you motivated through every interview. Because, I mean, the truth is that everyone asks pretty much the same questions, you know. And to keep that enthusiasm high from one interview to the next can be challenging. But like I said, it's the adrenaline. It's just the excitement of the film and the energy of the film that permeates into what I'm doing here right now.
And also the secret that you revealed to me at the Film Fair carpet, that happy girls are always the prettiest.
Yes.
And Diya Mirza is the best example for that one. So coming back to the movie, I'm sure you must have met Manyata. I would like to know from you, how did her personal experiences help you in building that character for the movie?
Honestly, I was so... I had such an advantage with the script and the research that both Abhijat and Raju sir had done, that it didn't really require for me to invest too much time asking Manyata questions. What I did do was I went back home and I watched some videos during certain timelines of her life that were relevant to the film, just to study her body language and just the way she was. And then it was just teamwork, the fact that the makeup and the costume department did such an effective job in making me feel like her.
And you look
with
like
the way
her
I look, yeah, in the film. That really helped. But the most important thing when we essay a part that we hope to achieve is a deeper understanding and insight of the circumstance and how that impacts you emotionally.
True.
You know, because what you can do as a human being is empathize with the person, but that empathy leads you to the honest emotional point that you want to achieve within the narrative. And and I was assisted greatly by the script. It really helped.
And like you mentioned, you actually lived the character for that period of time when you're shooting for the movie.
Yeah.
We have heard that many actors give their heart and soul into the characters, be it Ranveer Singh in Padmavat or be it Jim Sharov in Neeja. We also saw Ranbir Kapoor playing something very, very different. So also on the set, I would want to know from you, how was he when he was off camera? Was he the Dutt or was he Ranbir Kapoor?
He was, when the camera was not rolling, he was Ranbir.
He was.
But you know, I have to admit that his gait had changed completely.
Oh.
His body language, even when he was kind of relaxing in between shots, the way he would stand, the way he would sit, the way he would walk, would be Sanju sir. Like if you saw Ranbir in the distance and his back was to you, there would actually be moments when one of us would think that Sanju sir has arrived on set. It was crazy.
Okay. And also, did you have any second thoughts on taking up this movie? Because any second thoughts? No?
No.
Because this was after a long break. And of course, you know, you were into productions. You did not take up some acting projects. Long break and then a biopic.
I was waiting for an opportunity like this. You know, the reason why the break happened was because I consciously chose not to do films that I didn't believe in.
Okay.
You know, I didn't want to just... See, it's one thing to be a part of films just to stay in like what they call rotation or circulation. But after you reach a certain age and stage in life and you've kind of collected the experience that you require to get to that point, I think for me it was really about just stepping back and saying, one second, I've spent a large part of my youth working in film and I love the craft, I really care for the medium. Now that I was also producing it, I think my understanding of it had just improved significantly and my passion for it had increased a lot. And then suddenly I just felt that, you know, there's so much of yourself that you invest in a film. It's so much better to work than in films that you can genuinely deliver to and that you know that will get delivered to the audience. Because there's nothing more heartbreaking than working on a film and knowing that it's not reaching its audience. You know, that is the most terrifying thing and most painful thing for an actor.
And
I was done with that. I was like, I can't deal with this anymore.
I have to tell you, you don't have to be terrified this time because you have connected with the audience brilliantly looking at the trailer. Kudos to that first
of all. Thank you.
And also, since we know that Ranbir Kapoor is called the heartthrob of the nation, how was the entire chemistry, that love angle that you had with Ranbir?
I've always loved Ranbir. I think right from his first film. But the film that made me just completely fall in love with him as an actor was Rocket Singh. I was like just blown away by his performance in that film. He was just so fantastic, you know, and it was one of his first offbeat kind of commercial offerings, and it was such a beautiful
film.
And
I'm sure Rockstar as well.
Rockstar, of course, all of that came later, but Rocket Singh came before that, and by then he was like, this was it, you know. In my mind, I was like, wow, this man is so special. He is magic to work with, you know. He's one of the most real, grounded, normal human beings to be around. He doesn't have any superstar airs, and he's got one of the most incredible temperaments.
Okay.
You know, like I promise you, if it was you or me in his situation, sitting in prosthetics for like 5 hours, standing in sweltering heat, the noise of a set, the chaos that can be on a film set, and to not even like like for a second be agitated, is superhuman. It's unbelievable. I used to keep saying, do you like meditate? Were you born meditating? Like what is going
on? And he was all cool about
it. He's very composed. He's one of the most centered and composed actors I've ever worked with.
Okay, since you mentioned so many good qualities about Ranbir, and this is like a multi-starrer film with humongous names put together, what is that one certain quality about any one of the actors that stood out among the rest and which you would want to implement in your acting or in your personal life?
I would love Ranbir's patience.
Really?
Really, I think he's one of the most patient human beings I've ever worked with. I would love to have the insight that Vicky brings into his performance unknowingly.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, there's like this subconscious insight that he brings into a scene. It's beautiful. It's like he discovers it also himself and it's very refreshing. I would love to have Anushka's, I'm only naming the actors I've worked with in the film. I'd love to have Anushka's confidence.
Yeah?
Yeah. She's stoic.
So
she's
how we see her so very like, confident on
she's
the screen.
So together. It's not just on screen. It's just her, just like, you know, I'd be chewing my nails off before certain scenes because I'd be so worked up about delivering in it. And she would just be like, cool as a cucumber, on the ball, doing her thing, laughing and joking. Of course, we, you know, participated in that laughter and those jokes, but she's able to very quickly bring her attention back to it. I take a little time to come back to it. Okay. I get distracted very easily. So I would love to have Anushka's attention, her ability to just like focus.
So now after this movie, there are many actors, commercial actors who are venturing into web series. So
yeah.
Any plans of that?
Yeah, there's actually some very interesting offers.
Projects on.
Yeah, we are also producing some web series. Mm-hmm. I'm really excited about that.
Please start on web series now. Because it is the thing.
Listen, keep
right
your
now.
Fingers crossed. Like and make sure always. And pray that all the actors you approach say yes to it.
Okay, very, very last question. Since I was drowning in your beauty the minute I looked at you, that happens every single time. Quickly, I've seen many videos of yours giving many secret tips about beauty.
You have?
A lot. Yes, every single time. I've seen 4 or 5 videos. Quickly to our audience, just 3 of your routine or your daily tips that you swear by. Just 3.
Okay, so I've done all kinds of workout. I've done Pilates, I've done functional training, kickboxing, swimming, played a sport, all of that. But what I've realized and discovered is that if every one of us can achieve 10,000 steps in a day,
okay,
we are bound to be fit. So whether you do it through dancing or you do it at the gym or however you do it, whether you walk 2 times a day or you just spend more time on your feet through the day, 10,000 steps.
That's it.
A goal. Like now we have mobile phones that tell us how many steps we take, or you know, those Fitbits. So yeah, track your steps. That's 1. 2, there is nothing more important. I really think what we eat, we become.
Yes.
What we eat, we think, and what we eat, we become.
Become.
So pay attention to your diet. Mm-hmm. Try and eat natural food as much as unprocessed and unpackaged food as you can. Just go back to basics, you know, follow the traditional Indian food diet. So eat lots of sabzi and lots of dals and lots of fruits, and you're sure to be healthier, and that will start reflecting in your skin, in your mood, in every way. The 3rd tip would be meditate.
The most important
I one. I cannot begin to tell you how it has changed my life. And with every year that I have consistently meditated, I have discovered that it has benefited my ability to ground myself, center myself. It's improved my memory, my ability to respond. Like, you know, I feel a lot of our experiences in life are based on our reactions.
Yes, of course.
So I think meditation really manages the way you react to circumstances and people. And that can make such a big difference. So yeah, meditate.
I think that was perfect. Thank you so much, Diana. And do not forget to watch Sanju on the 29th
of June.
Okay, thank you so much.
So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it and share it. And of course, subscribe. This is Pop Diaries.